Hey guys, today, how to be a manifesting master. And it's really easy. Watch this. All you gotta do is focus on what you want instead of what you don't want. Now, there might be more to it than that. We could get into how to work with the law of attraction instead of against it. And if you would like advice on that, I have a whole playlist on this channel about the law of attraction. If you go to the main page of my channel, go to the playlists menu and look for the playlist called The Law of Attraction. And all the talking videos that I've made, like this one where I talk about stuff having to do with the law of attraction, are in there. And this one is going to be in there as well. So focus on what you want instead of what you don't want. This is a very important piece of this, okay? Because if you're focusing on what you don't want, guess what you're gonna get? You're gonna get more of what you don't want. So just focus on what you do want. Now, I know that there could be things going on in your life that you don't want, and whatever those things are, maybe they are being a real pain in the butt, right? Just whatever circumstances are going on, and it's something that you really don't want, and it's being a real pain in the butt. It's creating problems for you, headaches, and you're just sitting there thinking, how do I get this to go away? But here's the thing about how manifestation works with the universe. If you stay focused on it, you're gonna keep attracting it. So just don't focus on it. I mean, if you can fix something, fix it, right? If there is impending doom, and there are actions you can take to ward off impending doom, right? Then you should take those actions. But to be in this energy overall, continuously, of just always focusing on all the bad things that are going wrong in your life will create more drama, and it'll make those problems stick around. It's not any one action or thought or belief that you can take or have that's going to make the difference. This is a global belief that you have about the way things are. It's bigger than any one action or any one day, you know, having a good day, having a bad day, whatever it is. You have to kind of step back and look at your whole entire life situation over a larger period of time, you know, weeks, months. And if you have an overall essence, an overall energy, belief in your life that things are going the way that they are supposed to, or the way things are going the way that you want them, then that's what you're going to get. So that's what I mean by focus on what you want instead of what you don't want. And it works. If you focus on what you do want, if you focus on all the things that are working in your life overall, then you're going to get all those things that aren't working out for you to start working out for you. Watch this. Are we half full or are we half empty? You know what I'm talking about. We are half full. And if your cup is half full, then say that it is half full, right? You have to fill your own cup. What are you filling it with? And how are you looking at the substance in that cup? Focus on what you want instead of what you don't want. If you think you work too much and you would like more time for relaxing, then make yourself take time for relaxing. I know, but Kurt, I've got all these things I gotta do, and there's all these problems that keep cropping up, and I can't seem to get them resolved. Then just walk away from them for a while, okay? Get yourself into a different mindset. Be aware of the sponsoring thoughts that you are having. The thought behind the thought, behind the thought, behind the thought. The sponsoring thought. The prime thought that is causing all these other beliefs about whatever's going on in your life situation. And if your prime thought is, oh gosh, everything isn't going so well, things are not going the way that I want them to go, guess what you're going to get? You're going to get more little problems that crop up and less time to relax. Just as an example, right? Focus on what you want instead of what you don't want. I'm not saying walk away, be irresponsible, don't pay those bills, don't take care of things. But do you really need to sweat every little minute detail of your life every day, all day? Even when you're trying to relax. No, just let it all go. Do things that you do want to do. Like if you want to make time for relaxing, then make time for relaxing. Just make yourself do it. Like think of like any job you've ever had, maybe where you were an hourly employee. If you've ever had an hourly job, right? What happens when you clock out? You leave. You leave and you don't think about working anymore. You know, maybe if you were a salaried manager or something like that, you might be thinking about stuff that you got to focus on when you're at work. But for the most part, you know, some employee or something like that, when they clock out, they're done. You know, I work at a pizza joint. Let's say you work at a pizza joint. Are you really sitting at home thinking about making pizzas? No! You're relaxing. Leave work at work, right? Make yourself do the things you want to do and keep reminding yourself that everything is working out the way I want it to. You know, these problems will get worked out and you'll be surprised by how effective this is. Just try it for 21 days, guys. Just try massaging your primary beliefs about things. Everything is always working out. All these little problems that you're having, that you're experiencing, don't focus on them. Don't fret day in, day out over all the problems. Overall, your energy, day in, day out, you're focused on what you do want and what you do like doing, okay? You'll start to notice some of those little problems just kind of get worked out. Something happens, things start working out again, and it's fine. Don't focus on those things. Don't get sucked into the drama. Focus on what you want instead of what you don't want. It's really simple. It's really simple. And again, it's this total energy. It's your global belief system about the way things are in your life. If you believe that there's a bunch of little problems and things to worry about going on in your life all the time, then that's what you're going to get. So focus on what you want instead of what you don't want. Those of you that have been on this channel for a while, you know that I'm kind of a geek and I like science and science fiction and stuff like that, right? Do you guys remember the Apollo 13 movie? Do you guys remember that movie, Apollo 13? Based on the actual real events of the NASA Apollo 13 mission to the moon. And as a space buff, somebody who knows a lot about that, actual real space travel, like science fiction, like Star Wars and stuff, I don't know that much about it. Like Star Wars, Star Trek, I do like those things. But actual real space travel, that's what I'm really into. I've met all these astronauts. I've taught a class about the history of space travel. I know all about that kind of stuff. That movie was really accurate. The Apollo 13 movie with Tom Hanks, it was really accurate. The dialogue, everything was really, really well done. Well, anyway, at one point, the flight director, after the initial explosion took place out in outer space on their way to the moon, everybody in mission control is focusing on everything that's broken and what's wrong with the spacecraft. And oh my God, what a disaster. There's been multiple failures. We don't know what's going on. You know, they hadn't quite figured out that an explosion had taken place yet. They were still kind of like trying to figure out what was wrong, right? And the flight director right away, his name was Gene Kranz. He goes, wait a minute, hold on, whoa, 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 everybody quiet down, sit down, be quiet, everybody sit down. And he waits for everybody to sit down and be quiet. He goes, all right, listen. Maybe we need to look at this from the standpoint of status. What do we have on the spacecraft that's good? What do we have on the spacecraft that is still working? Right? And then from that point forth, they saved the mission and they actually brought the astronauts home alive. And everybody was pretty sure they were not going to make it back alive. Right? And then as soon as Gene Kranz came in and said, wait a minute, what do we have that is working? on the spacecraft and they started piecing everything together and they found a solution. It works. It works, guys. It works. What is going on in your life that's working? Focus on what you want instead of what you don't want. It works. I can vouch, and apparently so can NASA. Happy Thursday, everybody. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye.